scratch the surface yet. I think we're all still getting comfortable with one another. I think he's still getting comfortable out on the floor. But, you know, when he's attacking like that, the guy shoots high in the 80s, 90s from the free throw line. You know, that's easy money for him. And it's great for our defense as well. It's great for our team being able to settle a game down like that. So he was wonderful tonight, spectacular in all facets, both offensively and defensively. And we needed it.
Well, Shannon, how impressive was AD?
Hold on, you just said, since they started tracking minutes in the 50s, this is the fastest somebody's had a 40-20.
Unbelievable.
Crazy.
I mean, skip that. You know, your boy 51. I was born in 68. Mm-hmm. So we're talking about 17 years, going back 51. Well, we're talking about 68 years. There's been a lot of players. There's been a lot of players. Will. Bill Russell and Timmy Duncan are great. Elijah Wan, Charles Barkley, Karl Malone, Shaq. The man is the last Laker to get a 40-20 game since Shaq 16 years ago. Mm. See, this is why you move heaven and earth. Mm. You see, the Brandon Ingrams and the Lonzo Balls and the Josh Harts, they come along every NBA draft. Mm. But that guy, that's a generational talent. Mm. They only come along once in a lifetime, Skip Bayless. Mm. They don't come along all the time. And you move heaven and earth to get them. Mm. 40, 20, and 31 minutes. Oh, he had it going.
It's over.
He had it going.
It's over.
I told you. I said, he going to be the MVP, Skip. Mm. No. Anthony. Mm. Skip, he's been doing this. This is what he was doing last year in New Orleans that went unnoticed. Before the trade came up and they started jacking with his minutes, Alvin Gentry and Dale Demps. See, Dale, you got up out of there. Mm. Now, you could have still had a job, general manager of the Pelicans.
Oh, yeah.
Could have still had a job, but he joshing around. Now, look at him. Looking for work. Mm-hmm. Messing with me and Magic. me and Magic got pulled in this city.
Mm. Oh.
But anyway, Skip Bayless, you just saw this sample. Mm. A guy that can put the ball, he was attacking. So you're going to put it on the floor and say, okay, you can't stop me. And see, they made the mistake, Skip. They went small. You can't go small with him on the court because he's 6'11". And he's going to grab everything off the rim. I mean, he just, everything. And Clark, just give me that. Give me that.
How do they go big?
He's like a bullet.
Who's big?
They got Valanciunas.
Oh.
Valanciunas.
Yeah.
Yeah, he's like a bully. Call him a bully.
He's
a bully, yeah.
He moves like a glacier.
Yeah. You know, I'm a part of that anti-bullying campaign, except when it comes to AD. I let him bully them all, AD. Got something for you too, Porzingis, on Friday night.
Oh.
Got something for you, LaMarcus, on Sunday. Skip, you saw this.
Jeez.
Skip, that was special.
He's riled up.
Skip, that was special last night. And Bron. Bron, you know what? They messed up a couple of LeBron's pulled. They had like double this. JaVale messed up a couple of his assists. LeBron's pulled. They had 11, 12 assists. 23, 12. Look quiet. And I only had two rebounds.
Kind of quiet.
But, I mean, how you going to get all the rebounds when AD getting them all?
Yeah.
Can't get no rebounds, AD hogging them up.
So, by the way, LeBron James is now officially second fiddle.
No, don't worry about all that.
Is that what we're
officially
saying?
Officially, yeah. I mean, this is a first for LeBron.
Care.
It's a first that he is second fiddle.
I don't care. And we,
wow.
LeBron James, see, when he said, we're going to play through AD, you were the first one. I don't believe it. He said all the right things.
I still don't believe it.
Yeah, you believe it. You just said he's second fiddle.
Huh. Well, you know what? I kept looking at Memphis last night. I kept saying, who's that? Who's he? Wait, he's on Memphis? Who's that guy? And I started thinking, is this the Memphis G League team? I don't know because I can't recognize any of these guys.
Jay Crowder, Jaren Jackson.
Yeah.
Oh, hold on. Wasn't Jaren Jackson Jr. a high draft pick?
Yeah.
They got Ja Morant.
He went 2 for 10. Ja, after his coming out party against the Brooklyn Nets the other night, he had a grand total of 2 assists last night. He stunk it up.
Avery Bradley.
Yeah.
AB. Lock him up.
I'll buy that. But Ja, I thought Ja would
lock up.
You know,
Oh, Danny Green, Skip, he was special last night. This was this is why you move those pieces to get a guy like this, Skip. A 40-20 in 31 minutes, that speaks volume. So I'm not saying he's Shaq, but he's that level of talent to show you what he's capable of doing.
Mm.
And this is only a sample because, like I said, before that trade, before they started messing with his minutes, he was 29, 12 and a half, and 2.5.
Mm.
And this is exactly what he is now. But the difference is, Skip, guess what? You do 29, 12 and a half in a Pelican uniform, and everybody's like, so?
Mm.
You do 29, 12 and a half in that gold, that purple and gold.
Yeah.
People start going, oh, Mike and Shaq, Wilt, Kareem. We the land of the big man.
Yeah.
If you're a big man and you want to win, come to L.A. and put you in.
Is it possible the Lakers are going to play every game at home?
There you go.
I don't know. I'm starting to wonder.
You get 41 games at home.
Do you get to schedule all the Southern California college teams? Like I told you, Long Beach State is next. Maybe USC, UCLA. I don't know. Cal Poly, Pomona.
Well, Pepperdine beat the Clippers the other night.
Okay.
Phoenix Suns. They're Pepperdine.
Pepperdine's pretty good.
Yeah, the schedule gods have been
on their side.
No, they just hoping Malibu got a nice
Tell me when you're finished.
You go ahead, Skip. You got – oh, AD.
You good?
Oh, the AD. Woo.
You could go all day, Skip.
Shannon Sharp, I hate to rain on your very early season championship parade you got going here today, but at the center of all the good news about AD last night was some pretty stunning, not so good news.
What?
He had a bad shoulder. And it was so bad that he actually ducked the media the last 2 days and violated all the media access rules. Mm. I assume he'll be fined for that because he missed 2 straight sessions with the media because he was trying to hide a shoulder injury suffered late in the game against Charlotte.
He had a shoulder injury?
Hmm.
And put up 40, 20, and 31 minutes?
I think it's my turn.
Oh, my bad. I'm so sorry.
So he did have a shoulder injury that was so bad that they were afraid he could not play last night, and he did it by hanging on the rim late in the game against Charlotte.
Yeah.
One of those run-it-up dunks that he was trying to pull off against another bad team they played.
Stop it, Skip.
Yeah. And so he's got another injury, and I'm going to remind you that he missed an average of 17 games a season in his first 4 years, and he acquired the reputation or the handle of being brittle. Am I right about that?
Yeah.
And he's trying to sort of guts his way out of that. He said after the game last night, I'm trying to eliminate that label. But he accepted that, I was hurt with various injuries. He listed a bunch of them when I was in New Orleans. And the reason he went unnoticed in New Orleans is because he could never lift that team above 500. So that's what was going on there. So, Shannon, he already in the second quarter had to go to the locker room to get retaped with that kinetic tape.
Yeah.
So they had to retape him up. And then he came back against Memphis. And it's one of those nights where you're not sure if you can go and you sort of don't put any pressure on yourself. And you start thinking, wait, it feels better than I thought it did, because he could sure shoot free throws last night, couldn't he?
Yeah.
Because would you believe that Anthony Davis in the second half made one basket in the whole second half and scored 40 points. How can you do that? That's not possible.
Yeah, it is.
One basket and you scored 40 points. How did you do that, Mr. Davis?
You
made 18 free throws in the third quarter. That is the all-time NBA record for any quarter. Nobody has ever made 18 free throws in a single quarter. And he did it. And it's hard to get fouled that much in one quarter, right?
Yep.
That's a lot of times being sent to the line, and you made all 18 of your free throws, and what did he make for the game? 26 of 27. That is James Harden-esque. That is special.
And the thing was, the guy that had the record for the Lakers and the most free throws made in the game, people would have never guessed it was Dwight Howard.
Mm.
Dwight Howard once made 25 of 39. Remember Orlando?
39.
The hacker Dwight.
Hacker Dwight. But still, for Dwight to make 25 is staggering to me. I was shocked.
But anybody to make 25, that's a lot of free throws.
So speaking of our friend Valanciunas, after the game, he just went so far as to say, there were a lot of questionable things happening out there, as in bad calls.
Yeah, like the one you pushed Avery Bradley, or KCP, in the back, and then get a foul. You remember that one, Skip? Right up under the basket?
I think we might have that play.
Yeah.
Early in the game, I think this set the whole tone for the game, because underneath it got very physical, and there was a lot of pushing and shoving going on. I think we have, here we go. And AD's right in the middle of it. He tries to put it back. There's a lot of banging and crashing. He goes on the floor, and there goes Ty Jones on a little quick run out for a basket. And here comes your head coach, your new head coach, off the bench. Time out!
Yeah.
Because AD is still lying prone on the floor while the basket is being made at the other end.
And he asking, what is that?
Yeah.
He like, what was that bull jive that y'all just called? Or didn't call.
Okay. And I think your head coach sent the right message, because I think the refs got a little, started feeling guilty. And from that moment on, AD got every call known to man the rest of the game.
No, they fired him on the alley-oop. Yeah. LeBron threw the alley-oop from half court.
They went in and should have won. Oh, really? Okay. Well, how much?
This should not come as a surprise to you because he already has a 59-20 game on his resume.
So, again, How do you explain a guy making one basket in the whole second half and scoring 40? How do you do that?
Him.
That's got to be a first, too. I don't know how to look that one up, but
they fouled him. Yeah. Stop fouling.
The fewest baskets made in a half while scoring 40-plus points.
I mean, Skip, what did you expect? He had 20 and 12 at the half and then go 20 and 8 in the third quarter alone. Well, they should have put him back in there and see if he could get a 60 foul the game.
After the game, Anthony Davis said about his shoulder, it was bothering me a lot. It was very sore. You starting to fear this for going forward?
Well, guess what? We ain't got a game.
You sure he's going to be able to play in the next two games that we, you're